We see more and more dramatic images in the media. Flooded streets, waves crashing over coastal towns, fallen trees, destroyed homes, and communities forced to evacuate. These scenes raise an important question. Are extreme events becoming the new normal? And if so, why? I'm Professor Joaquim Pinto, AXA Chair in Regional Climate and Weather Hazards at the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology in Germany. In the first part of my masterclass, we'll explore the science behind extreme weather, focusing on two of the most pressing threats, heat waves and heavy rainfall, both of which are already being intensified by climate change. First of all, what defines an extreme weather event? Extreme weather events are defined by two key characteristics: low probability of occurrence and a high impact. They are rare, but devastating, standing out from regular weather fluctuations. Examples include, but are not limited to, heat waves, cold waves, heavy precipitation, droughts, tornadoes, windstorms, and tropical cyclones. Some of the recent and notable cases are the European heat waves of 2018, 90 and 22, which shattered temperature records across the continent. Extreme rainfall events leading to catastrophic floods in Central Europe in 2021 and, as you might remember, in Spain in 2024. But why is this happening? Extreme events don't just occur randomly. It results from specific atmospheric conditions that set the stage for these events. Let's break it down. Starting with heat waves. Summer heat waves are preceded by the formation of a large-scale high-pressure system, or anticyclone if you prefer, often referred to as an atmospheric blocking pattern. This system prevents cooler, unstable weather from moving in, but most importantly, it induces prolonged cloud-free conditions, allowing intense solar heating over days to weeks. In other words, this is why we don't often get bad weather in summer. One problem is that the system also dries out the soil, reducing the ability to cool the air through evaporation. This forms a dangerous feedback loop. Drier soils mean less cooling, which results to even higher temperatures, intensifying the heat wave. We know that the longer the high pressure system remains, the longer the heat wave and the larger the impacts. Now, how does this work for heavy rainfall? In this case, we see a stationary low-pressure system or a cyclone keeping wet and windy conditions in place for extended periods. High quantities of atmospheric water vapor, which when lifted and cool, form clouds, and a triggering mechanism such as a weather front or a mountain range that forces the moisture to condense and fall as rain. Normally, low-pressure systems travel long distances and thus the rainfall is spread over a large area. However, if the system moves slowly, a lot of rain will fall on the same location, causing devastating floods, just like the ones we have seen in Central Europe in 2021, in Greece in 2023, or in Spain in 2024. However, not every summer in Europe is scorching, and not every winter is mild. Put differently, extreme weather events in the middle latitudes do not happen every season. To understand why, we need to come back to the difference between weather and climate. By weather conditions, we mean the atmospheric conditions at a certain place and a certain time. Climate, on the other hand, is the sum from all weather patterns over a long period of time, typically defined as 30 years. We all have experienced that seasons are different, and there can be large variations from year to year. For example, the winter of 2010 in Europe was very cold, and the winter of 2012 was very warm and wet. And this is what we call natural variability. It is an important part of our climate and is determinant for what type of extremes can occur. However, climate change is shifting this baseline. And why? Because it's heating up both the oceans and the atmosphere, thus fueling the conditions that drive these extreme events. For example, a warmer atmosphere holds more water vapor, leading to heavier downpours and a higher risk of flooding. the relationship between temperature and rainfall can be exponential. Every degree of warming supercharges the atmosphere's ability to dump water. At the same time, rising temperatures are making heat waves more intense and long-lasting. To sum up, extreme weather is happening here and now and intensifying. Understanding the science behind these events is crucial for everyone. First, an extreme weather event is characterized by a low probability and a high impact. Second, it doesn't occur randomly. It results from specific atmospheric conditions that set the stage for these events. Third, unusual and long-lasting weather patterns play a key role both for heat waves and heavy rainfall. Finally, while the frequency and intensity vary from year to year, climate change is already making them more severe and more frequent. Now that we know what drives heat waves and heavy rainfall, join me in the next part of this masterclass to take a deep dive into their devastating impacts.